Hey everyone, today we're going to take a look at a game called Litil Divil. I got it in a bundle a while back and I've never heard of it, so I figured I'd give it a look. I mean, Halloween's coming up, so might as well do something spooky. Now I know what you're thinking when you see this title screen. Oh look, Pitbroke is reviewing another retro-styled game! Well, the joke's on you! It's not a retro-styled game, it is a retro game. Seems this game originally came out in 1993 for the Amiga and DOS, and then it got ported to the Philips CDI in 1995. Wait, the Philips CDI? Ugh, that can't be a good sign. Odd that I've never heard of this game. I mean, I did play computer games in the 90s. I played your Commander Keens, your Dooms, your Wolfensteins, your Cosmos, Cosmic, Cosmonaut, so whatever. And I have never heard of this thing. Well, maybe it's a little known gem ported to Steam for all to experience. Let's take a look. So this is the title screen, and that's our main character. His name is Mutt, and he looks like what would happen if the devil had a love affair with Spike from Tom and Jerry. The music in this scene is really odd. It's not bad per se, it's just not exactly fitting. I mean, inappropriate. Anyways, at least Mutt's animations are pretty nice, especially for 1993 DOS. Just one problem. How do we get past the title screen? Seriously, your dancing's cool, man, but I kinda wanna play your game. I try all the usuals, enter, space, escape, shift, control, alt, X, Z, when eventually I find that F3 moves it past the title screen. An awfully weird and unintuitive choice, but okay. So as soon as I push F3, it drops me right into the game. No menu screen, no tutorials, no exposition story, no place to set up my controls, nothing. Bam, welcome to the game, motherfucker. Have fun. First thing I notice, my control pad doesn't work. Well, this is an old game, so maybe I have to use the keyboard. Wouldn't be the first time that's happened on a Steam game, and I can always use Joy to key later if I really need the controller. So the arrow keys seem to work fine, so I can move, but I can't seem to attack or jump or perform any actions other than ducking by pushing down and this weird dodge thing when I push up. So again, I try all the usual buttons and nothing responds. I was about to give up and deem this game broken when I remembered that Steam actually had a manual for it. So I pulled up the manual and it told me that X and Z perform actions, F3 takes me to the options menu, and Control plus J lets me set it up to the joystick mode. Sweet! So I go back to the game, and they don't work. None of them do anything. Seriously, Control J doesn't do shit. F3 doesn't do shit, and I keep pressing X and Z, and it doesn't do shit. What the fuck, man? Did the manual just fucking lie to me? Did they just post the manual for an old version and expect it to work? How broken is this thing? I decided to do some research, and while Control J and F3 indeed don't do shit, seems that X and Z are the action buttons. Sorta. See, what you have to do is hold down Z or X and then press right or left arrow. This will cause Mutt to attack or jump or perform whatever action is needed at the time. I don't see how I'm supposed to figure that out on my own, but I have a feeling that my confusion with this game has just begun. And I want to mention that, at this point, both buttons seem to do the same thing. So, I beat the troll, and I go into this 3D dungeon, which kind of reminds me of the old arcade game Zybot. Not that anyone other than me remembers that game, or heard of that game, but it was kind of a cool game from, like, I think the early 90s. Anyways, for a 1993 game, the dungeon scrolling and perspective is actually fairly impressive. As cool as this part looks, it doesn't change the fact that wandering around here gets really monotonous and confusing really fast. Mainly because everything looks the exact same, and the little partial map they have up there doesn't help worth squat. Also, the perspective and character placement makes it really hard to avoid traps that you find along the way, and I swear, some of these are damn near impossible to dodge or predict. Eventually, you come across some rooms that kind of seem like dead ends at first. Like this room where I'm fighting this giant spider spitting out little spiders. The action button lets me stomp on the little spiders, but I can't seem to do anything to the big spider. And no matter how many of these little buggers I kill, she just keeps spawning them. I don't know what's worse, me killing the giant spider's babies or the fact that she doesn't seem to give a shit. Well, looks like I'm stuck. Let's get the fuck out of here. At least they let me do that. And then I find another room that has me hopping on sinking rocks in a moat. This part is really difficult because the controls are some wonky-ass Q-Bert shit. You like hit down and Z or X to go diagonally down right, and Z or X and right to go diagonally upright, and so on. It's really awkward. To make matters worse, I find myself accidentally hitting the Windows button when I try to press Z or X, and it will knock me out of the game temporarily, usually causing me to die. Like, this isn't frustrating enough. Whoa, where are you going? I'm not done yet. Yeah, if you mess up like 3 times in this area, Mutt will just up and leave the room. Man, have you ever had a video game character do that? He practically just told me, fuck off. I'm taking my ball and I'm going home. To make matters worse, if you do manage to get to the end of this level, you're stuck in a dead end where this face breathes fire on you and scorches you to ashes like a 1930s cartoon character. Toasty! Now look, I understand that a lot of classic games had some rather unintuitive gameplay at times. I know this because I grew up on NES games. Hell, I've played and beaten Friday the 13th on the NES, and that game's pretty goddamn unintuitive and confusing. I've also played the damn King's Quest series, and those games are pretty off the wall with trying to figure things out too. But those games feel like Super Mario Brothers in comparison to this thing. Not to mention, I'd like to point out that the manuals to those games at least didn't lie to me. So the third room you find is a shop. But even that isn't explained, as there's no shopkeeper and it just shows you items and numbers. Eventually I found some money and bought some bug spray in a bucket. So I went to the spider area again, and still I couldn't do anything. What I soon found out is now the controls changed. Z button stomps and X button uses the bug spray. Well, they both did the same thing until now. This game keeps changing the rules like it's frickin' schizophrenic or something. This game is more indecisive than a Libra with ADHD. I should know, I married one. Ba-doom! She exploded and a flashlight fell out. Okay, guess it's time to shine some light on this subject. Eh? Eh? Now, back to the place with the floating rocks. You now use the bucket to take water out of the moat and put out the fire breather who dissolves into a door. Yeah. Okay, well see, I'm not gonna question anything because something even weirder happened the first time I did this. I timed it wrong or something and both passed the level and died at the same time. I mean, look at this. This game is more broke than my wallet. You know what I'm saying? I need money. Seriously. They're threatening to break my legs. It really helped. Anyways. So, I got to admit, after passing those two areas, I actually got a little bit excited for a second. Started actually feeling like I was having fun for about a minute. And then I got bored again, because going through these dungeon mazes is boring as fucking shit. Joy. Eventually, I found a sumo wrestler I had to fight. Seemingly, Mutt knows some sort of shitty hurricane kick, because why not? Nothing else has made sense up to this point, so why should I expect it to now? No matter how many times I hit this sumo guy, though, I can't seem to pass him. And eventually, he slams me out of the stadium, and it actually kills me. When you die, some guy comes in, drags you to the torture room, and then performs some sort of hideous torture on Mutt while playing carnival music. See, the music makes it seem like this scene's supposed to be funny, but it's really not. Seems I need another item. So I have to traverse this maze all the way back to the start of the game where I can go to the shop, buy a pin so that Mutt can pop the sumo wrestler a la Bugs Bunny style. Sumo wrestler, meet the true power of Jenny Craig! You know know what? Fuck this game. Some classic games like the original Legend of Zelda and Metroid have their really unintuitive moments, but they still manage to be really fun and feel really rewarding when you figured something out. This game doesn't have that. It's just boring, frustrating, confusing, and goddamn is it a pain in the ass. This game is a steaming piece of crap now, and I'm sure it was a pile of shit back in 1993. I don't see why anyone would have felt it was a good idea to put this on Steam. Well, I bet it's at least cheap. I mean, I got it in a bundle, but let's see how much it costs, like, individually on Steam. It's gotta be like $1, $3. Let's look. $9.99?! You're charging $10 for this two-decade-old piece of dung?! And on further investigation, many resources say the Amiga version was the best version, and the PC version is like a far inferior port of it. So, the version on Steam is a bad port of the PC version, which in turn was a bad port of the Amiga version. So you're charging people $10 for a game that is not only 2 decades old, but is a bad port of a bad port. Aw, hell no. I've played better games on Steam than this for a tenth of that price. In retrospect, this game actually makes me feel bad that I gave Fist of Awesome a 1, as this game is just so much worse. So, I didn't plan to go this far, but I give Litil Divil 0 hells out of 5. The best part about giving a score that low is I don't have to find a reference picture for the score. But seriously, I can't possibly give this game a worse score without going into negative numbers. And I fear the day I find a game that makes me go there. Regardless, avoid this game. It's practically unplayable and it's not worth your money. If you really want to play a PC game from the 1990s, I'd recommend buying the Commander Keen collection on Steam. Otherwise, just avoid this game. You know, like when you were in elementary school and there was that kid in your class that ate pencil lead and was picking his scabs all the time and ate his boogers? You know the one. Because honestly, it's not worth interacting with him and it's not worth interacting with this game. See you next time.